morning students. Let's learn today increase or decrease as a percent. Okay, increase or decrease as a percent. Now you heard the words increase the population, decrease the population. You have heard or not these words? Last year population was 5 lakh. This year it is increase. This year's population it is 5,10,000. So how much it is increased? By 10,000 it is increased this year. Okay, so that we have to write in the percent. Means what it is given, increase or decrease as a percent. So that we have to write as a percent. Okay, so how to write that as a percent? See here one of the example I have given. So understand what is increase and what is decrease. Increase the population, decrease the population, that we have suppose if it is given in the number. But now we need to know in percent, means how much population, what percent population it is increased, what percent population it is decreased. Okay, so let's see this example. A school team won 6 games. A school team won 6 games this year. Okay, a school team won 6 games this year. Okay, against 4 games won last year. Means a team won last year 4 games and this year 6 games. Okay, this year it won 6 games. Okay, so what is the percent increase? So it increased or not? Last year it won 4 games and this year it won 6 games. So how much it won? By 2. But that we need to know in percent. So what we have to see, what is the percent increase? We know 2 games it won, but what percent it increased, that we have to find. So for that we have our formula. Percent increase. Percent increase is equal to amount change upon original amount multiplied by 100. Percent increase means we have to find the percent increase, na? Increase percent we have to find. For that what is the formula? Amount change upon original amount multiplied by 100. Now amount change upon original amount multiplied by 100. Now what it is? Amount change means here what it will come? Increase the number of wins. Amount change, this is just I have given the formula. Now in this example what it will come? Increase the number of wins. Okay, amount change. So increase the number of wins. Okay, upon, now what it will come upon? Original number of wins. Okay, original number of wins. Okay, multiplied by 100. Increase the number of wins upon original number of wins multiplied by 100. Now how much number of wins it is increasing? Last year 4 games it won and this year 6 games. So how much now increase the number of wins? 2. Okay, 2 number of wins increase. Okay, how much original number of wins? 4. Okay, 4. This year it increased by 2. Okay, last year, see, this year against 4 games. See, a school team won 6 games this year against 4 games won last year. Okay, so this year it increased by 2. So original number of wins? 4. Okay, multiplied by 100. Okay, it won by 2. So original number of wins? 4. So multiply by 100 we have to. Now do this calculation. See, this number is divisible by 4. 4 ones are 4. 4 twos are 8. 4 fives are 20. Okay. 2 multiply by 25. 2 multiply by 25. see one more example. The number of illiterate persons in a country decreased from 150 lakhs to 100 lakhs. Okay, in 10 years. What is the percentage of decrease? See now here, decrease. What it is given, the number of illiterate persons in a country decreased from 150 lakhs to 100 lakhs. Means how much it is decreased? Decreased by 50. Decreased by 50 lakhs. Okay. Lakhs to 100 lakhs means it is decreased by 50 lakhs. Now what it is asked? What is the percentage of decrease? Now 50 lakhs I have told in the number. Now what we have to write back in the percentage. Okay. So how much percent it's decreased? Okay. So now let's write here formula first. Percent decrease. Is equal to amount of change. Okay. Amount of change upon original amount. What it will come? Amount of change upon original amount multiplied by 100. Now see here. We have to find the how much percent it is decreased. Okay. How much percent it is decreased, that we have to find. Now see amount of change. How much amount it is changed? See what it is given in the question. Decrease from 150 lakhs to 100 lakhs. So how much it changed? See 150 minus 100 we have to do. So how much it changed? 50 amount changed. It is 50. 150 minus 100. So how much you will get? 50. Okay. So amount of change, what it is? 50. Why it is 50 understood? See, the number of illiterate person in a country decreased from 150 lakh to 100 lakh. 150 lakh to 100 lakh means it is decreased. So 150 lakh to 100 lakh. So how much it changed? By 50 it changed. So amount of change, how much it is? 50. So right here 50. Amount of change 50. And what is original amount? It is decreased from 150 to 100. Okay. It is decreased from 150 lakhs to 100 lakhs. So what is original amount? 150. Okay. Multiplied by 100. Now do this calculation. See, this upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. Now 1 multiplied by 100. Okay, and here 3. Now let's convert this into mixed fraction. Okay, so see here 33 threes are 99 and 100. So 33 integer 1 upon 3. Understood? So percent decrease. So percent decrease 33 integer 1 upon 3. Now let's learn prices related to an item or buying and selling. Now suppose I am the shopkeeper. Suppose I have my own shop. And see, I will purchase some things from the wholesaler. So I have my shop. In that, suppose I purchase the t-shirts. Okay. I purchase one t-shirt cost is 500 rupees. Okay. I purchase from the wholesaler. Okay. From the wholesaler, I purchase the things. Means I bought from him. I bought means I buy from him. For how much cost? One t-shirt for 500 rupees. And now, I kept in my shop and I sell it to the customers for 520 rupees. Okay. So, I purchased from the wholesaler. Means I buy from the wholesaler. So, that price is called the cost price. Okay. So, that price is called the cost price. And see, for how much rupees I purchased the t-shirt from the wholesaler? I purchased for 500 rupees. So that is cost price of that t-shirt. selling price. Okay, so cost price means, let's see, cost price. What is cost price? The buying price of any item is known as cost price. Cost price. The buying price of any item is known as cost price. So we can write CP also for that. Cost price. What is cost price? Understood? The buying price of any item is known as cost price. I purchased. I bought. See, I have my own shop and I bought some t-shirts. Cost of one t-shirt is 500 rupees. How much cost of one t-shirt? See, I am the shopkeeper. I am the shopkeeper. I bought some things, some t-shirts. I bought some t-shirts. Okay. So, for how much rupees I bought one t-shirt? Rupees 500. Okay. For rupees 500 I got. Okay. And I am the shopkeeper. Now, I kept that t-shirt in my shop for selling. And I sell that t-shirt for rupees 520. Okay. I sell that t-shirt for rupees 520. So, what is the selling price? 520. So, what is the cost price? 500 is the cost price. So, what is cost price? The buying price of any item. I buy the t-shirt for rupees 500. Okay. So, buying price of any item is known as cost price. So, what is the cost price of that t-shirt? 500 rupees. And I sell it for 520 rupees. So, what is the selling price? I sell it for the customer. For how much rupees? For 520 rupees. Okay. I sell it. So, selling price is 520. Okay. So, what is mean by selling price? See here, I will write here selling price. See, cost price understood. Now, selling price. Price at which you sell, okay, is known as selling price. Okay, selling price is SP. Okay, SP, we have to write in short SP, we can write. Okay, so what is cost price understood? What is selling price understood? We'll see about cost price and selling price. Okay. Cost price and selling price. Now, I bought a t-shirt for 500 rupees. Okay. I am the shopkeeper. I bought t-shirt for rupees 500. So, what is the cost price? Cost price is rupees 500. Okay. And I sell the t-shirt for rupees 520. Okay. So, what is the selling price? Selling price is rupees 520. Now, in this transaction, if you will see, 20, I got the profit. So, when the cost price is smaller than selling price, we get profit. When the cost price is smaller than selling price, what we'll get? We'll get the profit. Okay. Now, let's see one more example. Another example. Okay. So, now see here, I will change the prices. Okay. Suppose I bought a t-shirt for rupees 500. But I sell it for rupees 450. Okay. I bought the t-shirt for rupees 500. I am the shopkeeper. I bought the things from the wholesaler. So for how much cost it got? Rupees 500. So what is the cost price? 500. But I sell it for rupees 450. Then it is profit or loss? Obviously it is loss. I bought it for the 500 rupees. I buy it for 500 rupees and I will sell it for 450, means 50 rupees loss I will get. Na? So here cost price is more than selling price. See here, cost price is more than selling price, then it is loss. See, cost price is more than selling price. So obviously it is loss. So what is the formula for loss? Loss is equal to CP minus SP. CP means cost price and SP means selling price. Now cost price is how much? Rupees 500. And selling price is how much? Rupees 450. So how much loss I got in this transaction? I got loss rupees 50. So how much loss I got in this transaction? Rupees 50. See, what is the cost price? Rupees 500. And what is the selling price? Rupees 450. Okay. So see, cost price is more than selling price. Okay. Cost price is more than selling price. So obviously it is loss. So how much loss we got? Rupees 50. Let's learn now profit or loss as a percentage. The profit or loss can be converted to a percentage. It is always calculated on CP. Profit or loss can be converted to a percentage and it is always calculated on CP. CP means cost price. It is always calculated on cost price. Now see here one example. Cost price is equal to rupees 72. Cost price is given 72. Selling price is rupees 80. See here, cost price is less than selling price. Then what it is? Profit, na? Cost price is less than selling price. So profit. So what we have to find? Find the profit percent. To find the profit percent, first we should find the profit. Okay. So how much profit it is? So write the formula for profit. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. Okay. So selling price, how much it is given? Rupees 80. And cost price is rupees 72. Okay. So how much profit we got? See, 80 minus 72. How much it is? Rupees 8. So how much profit? Profit is equal to rupees 8. But what it is as find the profit percent. So for that first we should know profit. So let's find the profit percent. So profit percent. Profit percent is equal to what it is calculated on CP. Okay, so profit percent is equal to profit upon CP. Okay, profit upon CP multiplied by 100. How much profit we got in this transaction? See here, rupees A. Profit is rupees A. Okay, what is the cost price? Cost price is rupees 72 multiplied by 100. This is the formula for to find the profit percent. Okay, what is the formula for profit? For profit, to find the profit. SP minus CP means selling price minus cost price. So we got profit. Now we have to find the profit. profit. Profit upon CP multiplied by 100. Profit or loss can be converted into percentage, that you know, and it will be calculated on CP, means cost price. Okay. So now here 8 ones are 8, 8 nines are 72. Okay, so what we got here? 1 multiplied by 100, 100 upon 9. Okay. Now convert this 100 upon 9 into mixed fraction. See, 9 ones are 9. Okay, so how much it will remain again? 10, 9 ones are 9. 11 nines are 99 and 100. See, if you do not understand, you can do in rough. 100 divided by 9. Now it is easy. You have learned from 4th standard, I think so. Yes? 9 ones are 9. See here. 10 minus 9, 1. 0 will come down. 9 ones are 9. So remainder 1. So denominator 9, 11. Whole number part and see remainder we have to write as a numerical. Okay. So 11 integer 1 upon 9. So what is the profit percent? 11 integer 1 upon 9. Okay. See now next one more example. See cost price is equal to rupees 120. Selling price is given rupees 100. So find loss percent. It is asked to find the loss percent. So to find the loss percent, first we should know the loss. See, now here cost price is 120 rupees and selling price is rupees 100. See, cost price is greater than selling price. See, cost price is greater than selling price, means obviously it is loss. Yes, see, cost price is greater than selling price, then obviously it is loss. So what is the formula for loss? Loss is equal to cost price minus selling price. Loss is equal to cost price minus selling price. Now what is the cost price? 120 rupees. And what is the selling price? Rupees 100. Okay. So 120 minus 100, we got 20. Okay. So loss how much we got? Loss we got 20. Now what it is asking the question? Find loss percent. Okay. So to find loss percent, write here formula for loss percent. Okay. Profit or loss can be converted into percentage. Now loss we got. So let's convert into percentage and it is calculated on CP. It is always calculated on CP. So loss percent is equal to loss upon CP multiplied by 100. Okay, loss upon CP multiplied by 100. Now loss how much we got? Rupees 20. So write here 20. Cost price how much it is given? 120 rupees. Okay, and multiplied by 100. Okay, so now see here, upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. So what will remain? 2 multiplied by 100 upon 12. Now let's do this calculation also. 2 ones are 2, 2 6 are 12. So what we got? 100. See, 1 into 100, 100. 100 ones are 100 and upon 6. Now 100 upon 6. So again these both the numbers are divisible by 2. So 2 threes are 6, 2 5s are 10, 2 zeros are 0. Okay, we got here 50 upon 3. What we got here? 50 upon 3. So 50 upon 3. Now divide here 50 upon 3. Let's convert this 50 upon 3 into mixed fraction. 3 ones are 3. Okay, 5 minus 3, 2. 0 will come down. 3 6s are 18. Now 20 minus 18. 2 will remain. Okay. So what we got here now? Answer we got. See. We got here 16 integer 2 upon 3. What we got answer here? 16 integer 2 upon 3. So what is loss percent? Loss percent is equal to 16 integer 2 upon 3. Okay. Loss percent is 16 integer 2 upon 3. Okay.